It's already disappeared.
Nothing lives here.
He's gone. He's really too slow.
How could you keep going?
How could you keep going? Ignore the pain.
I told you it must trick you. We told you.
Where are you going? See, there's nothing to follow.
Come on.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbal, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren. And lonely. There he was. The lone figure of a boy. Salt lay under the shade of a tree. She remembers the first time she saw him. And her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom lifted. For the first time in years, she felt
the Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword is Sigmund's touch. His brother, King Sigurd, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him. So King Sigurd plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast. When they arrive, King Sigurd captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain,
But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Senua's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You learnt all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Come and watch. And bring your swords.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who's supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, and don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him. They will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here.
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
You want to believe it.
Is he
not real?
Is he there?
You're alone in these mountains.
Is that Delia?
Nothing lives here.
You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
As the she-wolf licks the sweet honey from Sigmund's face, he bites the wolf's tongue. The she-wolf pulls away, but Sigmund holds on. The chains break, and he is free. After his escape, Sigmund lives like us, hidden in the forest. His enemy, King Siggeir, believing him dead, as his sister plots revenge. And for vengeance to succeed, even the great Sigmund needs help. So she sends her sons to him. But their blood is weak and corrupted, and they're put to death by Sigmund. So his sister hatches a new plan, one that is cold of heart and pure of blood. Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless, and so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive. King in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place. Where are we? Where is she?
It feels wrong.
Where are we now? Burial mound. So strange that we go to such lengths to bury death. Something so very ordinary. Inevitable. It's as if we conspire to hide death. Because we have no answer for it. But when it comes and enforces itself onto our friends or loved ones, then comes the reckoning.
After he was killed, she's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword. Tyrfing.
He loves her. He loves her. It's not that he loves her. He loves her.
Dillian, I'm here. I'm here for the trials. Like when we first met, remember?
I'll find him.
Voices. Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian. Dillian's calling to you. Can
Where
you
is
hear?
He? Where is he?
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Think. Use your mind.
Where's he gone? He's disappeared. You let him slip through your fingers once again.
Think clearly. You have to find another way.
There has to be another way.
You don't recognize it.
Don't doubt yourself. You'll never find it.
She doesn't recognize it.
Yes, you do. You know where you are.
She doesn't.
Listen for his voice. Listen.
Dillian, where
listen
are you?
Listen for his voice.
Dillian, she can't hear it.
Does everything look the same?
It's the same. Something's different.
Look for clues.
What is it?
It's not him.
It's not him.
We told you.
It's not him, it can't be.
What's that sound? The voice is changing.
That's not Dillian.
That doesn't sound like Dillian.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
It's not Dillian. Father? I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
Chief Edson.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you, they will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
There's more. I'm tired, but you have to keep going. There's still more. There's always more to do. It's not going to be easy.
Say that their all-father, Odin, gave his eye in exchange for a drink from Mimir's well, the Well of Wisdom. In blindness there can be wisdom. Only by giving can you receive in return. For this reason, I give my life and pass on my stories of the Northmen to you, Senua.
Can you hear me?
Dillian.
I'm right here. Can't you see me?
No. Help me.
Breathe slow.
It's the darkness.
Stay still. Empty your thoughts. Tell me what you feel.
A breeze.
Good. Then there is a way out.
I can't tell where it comes from.
Yes, you can.
The others. The voices. They've gone.
I'm still here.
It's so quiet. So dark.
It's okay. Listen to your own breath. Feel it rise and fall. Good. Be aware of everything you hear and feel. Let your senses guide you.
Can't go on. Dillian?
Find a way. I'm not leaving you here.
I think I'm somewhere else now. The breeze has gone.
Use all of your senses. Let the world speak to you. What do you hear?
I hear water.
Go to it.
I've reached the water.
Good. That's your way out. Follow it upstream.
I'm so sorry. I thought I left us all behind.
Don't be sorry. It's not your fault.
He was right. It's inside of me. It won't let me go.
Senua. My father. He taught me the hardest battles are fought in the mind, not the soul. You're no coward. Prove that to me in a warrior trial. This is just another battle. You can beat it.
This isn't your battle. You don't have to help me.
I want to. Besides, you are going to be a great warrior one day. We need people like you.
I'll do my best.
See it?
No.
Then it cannot see you. Quietly move past it. One step at a time.
Not following me.
Leave it behind and keep moving forward.
There's more.
Breathing too fast.
I'm scared.
This is the sound of your breath. In and out. In and out. It will pass. You can do this, Senua. Thank you.
think I'm in a house. It stinks. Of death.
The darkness is testing you. You are in control.
There's a well.
Don't turn back. You're getting close.
Delia. Help me.
Come to me, sir. Yes, I can see you too.
She could spend hours, days even, trapped within herself in the dark.
You see me? Your eyes were open, but you were gone.
Yes.
And when it finally let her go, she could be anywhere, with no memory of how she got there.
When it comes for me, I have no power over it.
But here, for the first time, someone was there to help.
You found your own way back.
You brought me back.
All you needed was a little help. A little hope.
You've been fooled before, you could be fooled again.
You're being tested.
You don't know. It's just their game for you. You never know which way it's going to go.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
He loves you. Calling you.
Dillian.
Open the gate.
She can't.
Open the gate.
It's locked.
Try harder.
She can't.
Open the gate.
She can't.
She can't.
She will.
it. It's dangerous. Follow it. What's behind the gate? How will it take you? It's unsafe. Dillian.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Balder, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Balder's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
Precious to you.
He was the only one she could trust. Could she trust him? In a way that nobody else did.
Thank you.
She remembers him. He was the only one that really loved her.
He did love her.
She destroys the thing she loves. He's in the dark world. He's gone to the dark world. You're in the wrong world. He's empty. The dark world acts for you.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Balder. The blind god, Hood, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hood says, "I cannot see where Balder stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hood throws the mistletoe at Balder. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Balder is killed. And for this, Hood is slain. Northmen tell how the gods mourned Balder. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her reins. She pushes Balder's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Balder's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend, Dilia. She saw things no one else could. Patterns, shapes, movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds. That of Zinbel and her past. And Dilian, her future.
You have no time for this. Speedy.
Two realities tearing at her soul.
overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Just tell him. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur. Weep him out of Hel. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they find in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let Hel keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise. The Northmen tell how the gods punished Loki for Baldur's death. They captured him and took him to a cave. They fetched his two sons and turned one into a wolf, and he ripped his brother apart. The gods used Loki's own son's entrails to tie him down and turned these bonds to iron and dangled a poisonous serpent over his face so that its venom would drip onto him. Each time the venom drips onto Loki's face, he writhes in agony. The Northmen say that is the cause of earthquakes. A reminder, perhaps, that if even gods must accept death, then so must we.
Thank you.
much cared for the underworld. I look dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he took after his father, a chieftain who believed nothing he couldn't see. And he happened to be blind. She felt safe in Dillian's arms, and to see the world through his eyes. Slowly, the darkness that had bound her so tightly began to unravel.
Senua, your father cannot understand your darkness. He cannot see through your eyes. No one can. My own father was born blind. Doesn't have the faintest idea of what the night looks like. The word dark to him means as little as the word light. So someone is afraid of the dark. We fixed them by taking away their sight. Would you give up the beautiful world that you, and only you, can see just to be rid of your nightmares? Or is this the price you pay for the gift you have? The gift that makes you so special in my eyes. Just another part of the person I love.
I left for the wilds to protect you from my darkness. Because I love you. But it made it worse. I'm so sorry.
Killing you would be too easy. They're taking your memories to torture you. They're taking you from the inside. You're disappearing one memory at a time. Every time you remember, it disappears. They're going to take everything. They're not yours anymore. They're going to take everything you have.
The memories of ghosts.
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it. This place feels... It doesn't feel right.
What is this place?
It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Down back.
This there he is.
Dillius.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone? Keep going.
How do you find it?
It's just a trial. It's just another test.
You just have to find it, and then you'll find it. It's a test. Like the old warrior trials. Dillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? No. Don't worry. Not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. But the water... she could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong, something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing. And they knew that she was not like that.
It's broken. Now you have to find him. Quick, get to the house. Get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm. At first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
found a way. To climb the tower.
The ladder.
Quick. What now? You can see it. A line to the truth. The bridge.
Come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there?
Yes. Find him.
Come out if you want.
I have to find him. The runes. Focus.
Dillian! They're coming for me!
It's close, move away. Senua, move away.
You feel it.
You're done.
You're dying. The burning has
She's
begun.
Dying. The burning.
The burning has begun.
Those
there
are the gates. There they are. The focus.
You've got them.
Where's the door?
We have to find a way out.
Find the gate.
Run!
Run! Run now!
Run! It's not safe here. Run!
Send one. Run.
You don't need your sword.
You came through the wrong door.
Where's your sword?
Defend yourself. The burning has begun.
There is
the gate. There they are. The ruins. You can get through.
Run!
Run now!
Run! It's not safe here. Run!
The light. Go towards it.
Find us.
Focus.
Look.
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. It doesn't make sense.
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I am. You're not a monster.
Reforged, you will have Odin's blessing to walk a goddess into the halls of Helheim and challenge Hela as an equal.
So Dillion was helping me. And a sword will lead me to him. Like when we first met.
Thank you.
Dillian gave her the strength to pass the warrior trials, and she saw a way out. To leave her past behind and become a warrior in Dillian's clan.
The sword is tainted by the gods of darkness. Leave it.
No. He left it here. He wants me to take it.
You will pay a price for this.
But years later, with Zinbal's parting words still haunting her, the darkness came back with a vengeance. Plague.
Dillian?
Everyone suffered.
My father was not supposed to die like this.
Dillian.
Do you see it clearly now, Senua? The suffering you've caused.
This is your fault.
You brought this plague to us! You have blood on your hands!
They're coming for you now.
They're coming.
They're coming to get you.
Hold your heavy strike. Hold it. Hold the heavy strike. Hold your strike. Unleash the sword.
She's coming now.
She's
got it. She's so weak. You can see that. The focus is building.
It's building.
Over the ones I loved. The ship broke up under them. The ship that had sailed from the land of shining fields. Their memorial stone a secret. Come not here in the sun. Come not with a sword. Come not crying over a naked corpse. Come not with disturbed mind.
Does your precious gift of sight let you see the souls that rot here in this sea of corpses? Do you feel the blood running cold on your skin? Do you hear their endless cries? Do you smell their putrid wounds? They were once brothers, sisters, and loved ones. Look at what you have done to them. All because you were a coward, because you ran from your curse instead of facing it. When you turned your back on the father, Zinbal, and you turned your back on the gods, and let the darkness wreak havoc on your people. Why must they pay for your heresy?
Thank you.
voice of your mother, Galena. She calls for you, Senua. Go to her. Answer her pitiful call.
Darkness took her life, and it will take...
Mother! I need you! Help me!
Finish this! She's racing! You ready?
son is already dead. Just look around you. What hope is there for you? The new soul rescued. Do you think he'll thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
Fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? I want to be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother. To go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong.
Zimbal was right. Everyone will suffer.
Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word, never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope. into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's not far. Go on.
Look.
Just up there. Listen to us.
That's it. Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she?
Look.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf, Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open it.
No, go in. Don't open it.
What's happening?
A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you save Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadow?
They can't stop me.
Then do it. The beast is stalking you from the shadows. Your sword is useless here. Don't fall for it.
It's me, Senua.
It's so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate. I just want to help them. Tell me what to do.
Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them.
But he's gone now.
But he always comes back. He says I will die if I go with them. They want me with them.
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to
see them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming. Senua, help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards...